I want to start this video off with a huge thank you to younger me, 15-year-old me, who decided that schoolwork was for dorks, didn't try to do any sports, and did everything in his power to do the bare minimum just to get by. And thank you for his valiant service. My 40-year-old ass is out here doing this. Thank you so much, younger me. What a hero you are. Hello, everyone. How are you? It is now about 10 p.m. In the last video you watched, I was shutting down because of the Wyoming weather, which forced me into running all night. Boy, did that video bring out a lot of angry truckers. Hello, angry truckers. How are you? You're lucky I'm tired, because I'd have all kinds of jokes for you right now. Don't worry. I'm not too tired to drive. I got a little bit of sleep. Got a little bit of sleep, and the roads are okay right now. No chain laws up, nothing like that. I'm chained up still, and I'm going to use those chains to get out of my parking spot, because I got a feeling I'm going to need them. Then I'm going to remove them right here in the parking lot, and then we are going to hit the damn road. That's what we're going to do. So we're getting ready to head out. But, yes, geez, wow. That video seems to be doing well. Thank you, guys. Thank you. Even those of you that are angry, thank you. Even the angry views count, so I appreciate that so much. Hey, we're getting ready to run. So there were some current concerns. That's what I'm going to do for the first few minutes of this video, is just address some concerns. Why not, right? I'm allowed to communicate with you guys. There were some concerns about, you know, the load's just going to have to be late. Why are you worried about it? Stuff like that. I'm not too worried about it, but this is finally, like I said in the last video, of 3 weeks of just, you know, kind of mediocre weeks. This is finally that shot to have an absolutely huge week, and I'm going to get it. And the load's not going to be late. All I have to do is modify my schedule so that I'm running overnight now instead of running during the day like I normally like to do. 909 miles to go by Friday morning, 7:30 a.m., and it is currently Wednesday night, and we're just getting ready to start our day. We got this, baby. We got this. Now, I am the type of driver that will just, when it's time to be realistic and say this isn't going to happen, then make that known to everybody that needs to know about it and just shut it down. Say, hey, you know what? Too bad. Load's going to be late. That's just the way it goes. But when it is still in my power to get that load done, that directly affects my bottom line, right? I would be absolutely foolish to not look for solutions every time when something wasn't going the way I hoped it did. Look, my fat ass is having a Pepsi. Caffeine for the night. Been off the old sody pops for a while, but we're probably going to need that caffeine. But we don't have full days to run. 450 some miles per day. That's not bad. We're going to run obviously more than that tonight. We're going to leave as little as possible for tomorrow's night shift while obviously not running too much up against our 11-hour day, because, like I'm trying to tell you guys, I'm here to make money, right? I don't necessarily like that I never do resets, but I always like the option being there for me to have more time to run in the event that I need it, or maybe I get an extra dispatch every now and then, things like that, like what I'm setting myself up for this week. So having the hours is important. So if that addresses that concern, everyone, I am a lease operator, and I think I'm in a actually fairly good lease, because it doesn't, here's the big thing I like about it, I pay for the truck by the miles that the truck runs. That's what my truck payment is, right? So I can actually realistically afford to shut down without having a massive truck payment putting me into the negative the next week. That's obviously a good thing, but I'm obviously not the world's greatest businessman. If I was, I wouldn't be in a lease purchase anyways. I would still have one of the trucks that I've owned before, but I do no longer have them, which forces me right now to find solutions to eventually help me get back to that point. What I'm trying to say is, I think I covered it earlier, it would just be absolutely ridiculous of me to find reasons to shut down. I am in the business of finding solutions, my friends. And that's what we've done today. Yeah, it's inconvenient as hell. It sure is. But we're going to get it done anyways. And then, of course, you always find a way to summon the super truckers by putting on chains, right? God damn it, you guys. I'm trying to be the old super trucker now, and you guys come in here and out-dumbass me every chance you get. We got a guy that obviously has ended up in the ditch many times in his trucking career that came in to let me know that anybody that puts on chains or shuts down are a bunch of pussies. And that opens up the road for the real truckers to get out there. Yeah, the real truckers that are always in the fucking ditch. You might pull the wool over the eyes of the young guys that just started trucking out here, but I've been at it for long enough to know that your goofy ass running around with chains is not the sign of a real trucker at all. As a matter of fact, you look like a complete clown out there when you decide to just ignore chain laws. We know what happens to you guys. And you're just not greater than nature. You have to accept that. When you're doing a job like this where you're working with the elements out here, you have to accept that sometimes you have to concede defeat, whether that be shutting down. Now, I didn't shut down because I wanted to, all right? I am one of the last few remaining truckers out here that will throw chains. I will. But I shut down because they closed the interstate. What the hell was I supposed to do? You know, I didn't have a choice. So I shut down. Now, I could have stayed on the interstate and I wouldn't have got stopped at that on-ramp to get back on that they had closed. But I like having fuel in my truck. Call me crazy. So I stopped to get fuel. Also, I was very upset that I always run my truck so low on fuel. That's not what happened. What I said was I was on track to make it to the place I had on my GPS to stop and get fuel when the roads went to hell on me. So I made the decision that I should put fuel in the truck in the event that I might be sitting here for a few days. I had to sit here for a 10-hour break. That's just burning fuel because I'm idling the truck in this weather. It's 28 degrees out there. I learned my lesson the last time I tried to run my APU when it was well below freezing, which caused me a whole lot of APU issues. Now, it was much colder that day. It was like 5 degrees. I got something in my eye. That's why I'm winking at you like this. I got something in my eye, but I learned my lesson, and anytime it's below freezing, I idle the truck, and I knew if I was going to idle the truck, I was going to need fuel. But big question I have is, why the fuck do I have to justify putting fuel in my truck? That's fucking weird. What do you guys do? You guys that are angry that I put fuel in my truck, what do you put in the fucking thing? Tell me your secrets, because I want to know. Anyways, I'm getting ready to pull out of here, I guess, and get this party started. We're going to run, I'd say, at least 500 miles, get it down to... I'd like to get it down to about 360 miles for the next day. A little six-hour drive. I figure everything at 60 miles per hour. That's the way my mind works. It makes it easier for me. So if I can get it down to 360 miles, we are going to call it a day at that point. Sleep good. That's what we're going to do. Sleep good. Get ready to get up for the next day. I am going to be on my dispatch's ass tomorrow morning, telling them to go ahead and make sure I'm pre-planned because they are sending me into Seattle, and I do not want to be sitting in Seattle without any idea where I'm headed next, because Seattle is not a friendly city for truck parking whatsoever, and I am going to demand that they have a load pre-planned for me. I'm going to say, I'll be there. I've got this. Now make sure I'm pre-planned because I don't want to drive 40 miles out of Seattle in the wrong direction because you guys couldn't be bothered to pre-plan me. So there is that little casino up north, but it's I think it's pretty far up north. Not really sure. It's been a while since I've been there. Anyways, I'll leave you guys to it for now. I'll bother you later in the morning to tell you about the night's journey. See you soon. Oh, what's up, everybody? The rare shot without the hat. I'm trying to relax right now. We are getting it done, folks. Yes, we are. Yes, we are. Oh, my God. It's about 2 in the morning right now, and we've made it up to Idaho. But Daddy is very sleepy, so we're going to take us about a 2-hour nap. And we're ahead of this load still by about 5 hours right now. That's figuring everything at 60. You know, Idaho, is pretty easy. You got some hills out there, but then of course when you get into Oregon, you've got some climbs over there, and then I think Washington, guys, I'm headed through the apple orchards. Wish me luck. I might not survive this time. I've really been pushing my luck with those fucking apple orchards, haven't I? So wish me luck. I hope I make it. Yeah, we're going to take us just a little nap, a couple hours, and go do this thing. Get this done. We got 682 miles to go, and it was that last 30 miles of Wyoming that was the worst part of it. And since then, it's been perfectly clear. So my whole schedule got screwed up over 30 miles, and that's why we're doing this. So whatever, it is what it is. You know, this is how trucking is sometimes. You know, we gotta make things happen and get things done, and that's exactly what we're doing, right? That's exactly what we're doing. So I gotta check how I'm parked here at this rest area, because it's very small out in front of me, and I don't want, you know, I'm only gonna be here for like 2 hours till like about four in the morning, so the odds of someone moving are kind of low, but I don't want them to have to try to get around me. So I'm gonna check that real quick, and maybe I'll back up just a little. Oh man, we're getting it done, baby. We're getting it done. 682 miles to go. I don't even know if I mentioned that, but yeah, we're gonna get up with let's see, 7 more hours to drive. Obviously we're not gonna drive all of that. I'm trying to get it I said 360 earlier, but now I feel like that math is a little screwy. But that's only 320 miles away. Oh, I'm good. Yeah. 682 seems like a lot more than it is. We're okay. Yeah, we got this. We got this. So here's my plan before I go take my nap. Kicking my ass. After this, I'm gonna get up and drive, of course. And then when I stop for the day, I'm gonna send dispatch a message that's saying I will make this load on time, and I'm gonna ask them to pre-plan me. Like, I never normally ask, but you guys probably know that are also truckers. Seattle is a very trucker not friendly place, right? For parking. So I want them to pre-plan me today so I know which direction to go as soon as I'm done unloading there in Seattle. So I'm gonna ask for that, and we'll see where we go from there. Anyways, I'm gonna get my tired ass back there and get a little sleep after I check where I'm at. Only I would think it's acceptable to put out a video where I'm yawning repeatedly, but I guess sometimes we show a little bit of the reality of being an over-the-road truck driver. And I wasn't able to get back to sleep yesterday. I think I slept for like 2 hours, where I had a weird dream that I didn't tell him about it. He's finding out about it in this video. But the guy that helps me out with my thumbnails and different video topics and all that, I had this weird dream where he was sitting in the driver's seat of my truck when I was trying to sleep yesterday. And I think it was a little bit of the sleep paralysis. Does anybody get that? Anybody else? Because it felt very real. It was like almost a hallucination. But he was in my truck and he was just being a real dick. I don't know why. And he ripped my TV off the wall mount and told me I could go fuck myself. And then after I woke up from that, I ate some Taco Bell and tried to go back to bed, and I couldn't. I don't know if those two things are related or not. But anyways, yeah, my thumbnail artist is also a terrorist in my dreams. Not like an actual terrorist. He just shows up and fucks my truck up when I'm trying to sleep. And that's not very nice of him now, is it? Not very polite at all. Anyways, I'm gonna get to bed because I'm just rambling like a crazy person now. I'll talk to you guys in a little bit. Bye bye. Oh, good morning, everyone. It's 2 a.m. and we're getting ready to head out. Not good news. Not good news today, but whatever. That's okay. already cold out here. We'll get in the truck and we'll talk about it here in a minute. Well, good morning. Hello. I was in a good mood, but that got destroyed pretty quickly. It looked like this trip coming over here the rest of the way was going to be pretty clear. And then I got up this morning and checked the cameras. I'm in Oregon right now. If anybody didn't recognize the world famous truck corral, of course. So yeah, Baker, Oregon, getting ready to go up the mountain, Cabbage. And I was looking at the cameras, and in parts they looked pretty bad. They looked pretty bad, but there was nothing about chain laws or anything. So I went in to get my drinks, and the cool thing about these truck stops over here is they keep the webpage open a lot during this time of year, and they keep everything updated. They've got a board inside where they're showing everything, and it says just to carry chains. And then I asked him to double check, hey, could you have a look? Because it's a little easier for him than it is on my phone, and why not, right? He said there's one part that chain laws are up there. Gotta be honest with you guys, I'm sick of putting chains on. I am. So whatever, it is what it is. We have to get up there and get it done. So that's what we're gonna do. They moved my appointment time on this to 11 a.m. I'm due to be there between 8 and 9 at this point with what we got going on. I took a little extra time in the sleeper. I slept a little longer than I should have. And hopefully that isn't what's fucking me. It might be. It's not going to make me late for my appointment, but I don't know if it's what pushed me straight into having to put on chains here in a little bit. I'm not excited, guys. Just thinking about it, I'm already cold and angry out there throwing chains, so whatever. I've gotten better at it this year. It's been a while since I put on chains, but this year's gotten me back up to speed, you know. But anyways, whatever. I'm just grumpy right now. It's 2 in the morning, and I'm probably going to have to end up putting on chains, and I'm not excited at all about that, but this load has to get done, guys. I don't know how to stress it anymore. I'm out here to make money. I'm not out here to screw around and find reasons why I should shut down. This one's got to be done. This one's going to provide me a big week if I can get it done. So whatever, here we go. I'll talk to you guys soon. All right, folks, what do we got up here? I know you can't see it very well because my headlights are just shining off of it. But we've got a sign coming up. Look at these roads, though. These roads look good, right? Oh, yeah, of course they do. Of course they do. All right, we're climbing up the mountain, though. What do we got? What do we got? Chains required on vehicles, towing, and it's going to be 1 mile ahead, 1 mile ahead. So what happens, guys? Here's what happens. A lot of guys see these roads. Here, let me get these brights back on. And they go, what the hell? I don't need chains. Why would I need chains, right? Well, what's about to happen is you're going to gain a ton of elevation in a short amount of time. And you're going to be up there in the snow in just a few minutes. So I know it looks weird. Well, my windshield looks like shit. Sorry, guys. Anyways, it says this is the chain-up area right here. Anyways, wrong gear. Sorry about the picture, guys. That is ugly. Ugly. I can't get it to focus. Let's see. Nope, it just won't focus. Anyways, a lot of guys will see the chain law up, and they'll be like, oh, I mean, what's wrong with these roads? They're fine. Well, it just said chains are required, right? So there must be something going on up ahead of us. And actually, this is kind of nice. It's not good for the chains. Once again, I apologize for the way the picture looks. It's not good for the chains necessarily to be driving on this shit, the dry roads. But hey, it says they're up. We're going to put our chains on. It's kind of nice because we're going to put them on. What am I trying to say? We're going to put them on when it's not dumping snow all over us on somewhat dry land here. And the reason I'm still driving. God, this fucking image looks like shit. That's crazy. The reason I'm still driving is because I'm going to go as far up this chain up area as I can before I start putting chains on. A little less time that I have to put them on the dry pavement, but it ain't going to take me long to chain, 10-15 minutes, especially in these conditions. This is a really nice situation for chaining, honestly. Well, we're going to get her up over the mountain, and oh God, I am beat down, my friends. I am wore out. Oh, this is a bridge. Let me just move over here a little bit. And maybe I screwed up here a little because I don't want to be chaining up on this bridge necessarily. Maybe I should have done that back there. Now I got to find me a spot. Damn it, you guys can't see anything. I'll talk to you soon. All right, my friends, we are all chained up. Obviously, the roads still look very nice, but that may have been the last chain up area. Who knows? Who really knows? And my fat ass is sweating in here because it ain't even cold out there. I'm just kidding. It is cold out there. Anyways, that's the wrong gear. All right, there we go. There we go. We'll get her in the right gear here, and we'll start climbing the mountain. So it took me a little longer than expected, 23 minutes to chain up. What happens after when you use these chains a few times is they kind of get like stretched out. Think like what dumb men think happened to vaginas, right? Oh, you don't want that, dude. It's all loose and stretched out and shit. Oh, relax, bro. She wasn't gonna fuck you anyways. You're just making excuses, right? But that's what happens to the chains. And I actually have one that I'm a little concerned about. I'm not sure how it will do. We might not have it by the time we get done. We might not have that one by the time we get done. But that's kind of what happens. You use the chains a few times, and then they do break. They get stretched out, and they're pretty well useless. I do have one bag of brand new chains still that hopefully we don't have to use the rest of the year. Hopefully. Anyways, my friends, I don't have much more to say right now. We're going to get up this mountain, and if it looks like hell up here, I'll get you some more video. Talk soon. I don't know, folks. What do you think? You think this really needed chains? Probably. That's probably more slick than we realize. But, hey, we're getting it done, man. We're getting it done. I don't have to have the chains on much longer. I think it's just this part of the mountain. Farther over, closer to Pendleton, it doesn't look like it's too bad, but when I get to the chain removal area, I'll check just to make sure so I don't have to chain up twice. But hey, after I get over this mountain, I should be home free. When I stop to take the chains off, I will check Snoqualmie over there by Seattle. It's supposed to be good today. It's supposed to be just fine. I'll check that. There is a way around that. I'm sure my other truckers know that, but hey, you know, every once in a while you get a little nugget of information from me. It only adds 100 miles to get to Seattle coming from this way. If you just bounce over to Portland and then up I-5, you do have to deal with Portland though, but not a whole lot of it. But hey, if you've got the extra time, or you know, it's just too dangerous to head over Snoqualmie, then you just bounce over to Portland and you maybe end up late, but at least you're not bad, because that's a motherfucker of a mountain. This one, I guess it's pretty bad too, but Snoqualmie is more intimidating to me than this one. Maybe because I've only ran over there a few times ever, but it just seems to go on and on and on forever. Where this one, you know, it's not too bad. It's not too bad, I don't think. But that's what we're going to do. That's the plan. So there's really not much more to add at this point to the video. I will talk to you guys when I get where I'm going. But this is sort of what we're up against. It's not the worst thing ever. I'm just rolling at about 30. As of right now, it sounds like all of my chains are still intact. Hey, we'll just get it done. We'll just get it done and get over there and get this delivered. And hope we get that next good load to make it a big week, make some goddamn money this week. So once again, talk to you guys in just a little bit. Ladies and gentlemen, we are beginning our descent into Pendleton, Oregon. Please hold on to your ass, son. it is not fun out here. It's a little bit ugly, if I'm being honest with you guys. So yeah, it ended up being the full length of the mountain that we needed the chains on. What was, maybe these guys were already on the mountain. I try to mind my business as much as possible. There were people right here before we started dropping down in that chain up area, getting their chains on. Maybe they were already up here for the night. You know, there's some parking up here, but that was a little bit shocking to see. But hey, not my business, not my business. We are going to take it nice and easy down this mountain, guys. 20 miles per hour, 25 somewhere in there. And we're just gonna roll on down. I am excited to see dry land. Normally at the bottom, it's real nice, but pretty sketchy today, to be honest with you. It did get pretty bad, and this hill doesn't normally bother me. This used to be my favorite mountain in the entire country, and I would get so excited to come over here and run down this mountain. And nothing's changed about the mountain. I just got older and more grumpy, and I've seen it 1,000 times now, so I don't really give a shit that much. But today it's a little exciting. You don't want to be fucking around over here today. So I stopped in the chain up area because I had a bunch of snow underneath my windshield wipers, and that was making it real difficult to see. And so I stopped and did that. So anyways, we're just rumbling down the road, guys. This is I'm not having fun, if I'm being honest with you. I'm not having the most fun I have ever had. So we'll just hold her steady. A snowplow would be fantastic. That would be a great idea today, have a snowplow. So I normally don't do this, what I just did. You guys didn't see it, obviously. I normally am fine with running my jakes down a mountain like this on snow and ice, but this is a little intense. So we just turned off the jakes. What we don't want is that trailer sliding out from under us, right? We don't want any of that. So we're just going to take her nice and easy down this mountain. Just run it down here slow, because we do not want to be fucking around. This is probably the worst I've ever seen it. As I said just a minute ago, I have ran this mountain thousands of times. But this time, I don't know if you heard that in my voice, it was a little bit shaky. This time, it's making me a little bit nervous, if I'm being honest with you. This is ugly. So, hey, you know, we'll just do what we have to do. We'll get her down this mountain, hopefully in one piece. It takes a lot to rattle this old man. But this mountain is doing it today, if I'm being completely honest with you. It's definitely giving me a hard time. But we are so close to being down. The key right here, when you're so close to being down, is just patience. Just nice, easy. We're only going like 15. We're only going like 15 right now. You don't want to fuck up. You know, you don't want to do that. One thing I'm a little worried about is I am a little heavy on the brakes right now. Let's go ahead and let off those. Let them relax a little bit. And we don't want to be riding the brakes all the way down the mountain. We'll give it some brakes as much as we can as we continue our descent down this mountain. Good Lord. Part of what's screwing with me is my vape batteries just died, so I had to plug that in. So I can't even get me a hit of nicotine. All right, we'll let those brakes chill out for a minute as we just kind of coast down the mountain. I'm comfortable with like 25 at the most, but it don't take much to push this truck up to 25 miles per hour. We are definitely loaded, 40,000 pound load. Not great, let's say. All right, there we go. Nice and easy, nice and easy. All right. We're getting it done, my friends. We're getting it done. But yeah, I got to be honest, I am pretty nervous this time. Hopefully, we start to see drier roads now. The altitude drop on this mountain happens very quickly. You hear how fast the truck just wants to go? Go ahead, dude. Let's just go. We're gonna get through it, my friends. We are gonna get to it through it. We're gonna celebrate at the bottom. But if this had been any other week, where maybe I had a few good weeks before this one, I probably would have done this different. Somebody brought up an interesting question in the last video. They said something to the effect of, do you think that the way that truckers are paid contributes to the accidents that happen with trucks on the road? And the answer is absolutely yes. Absolutely. You know, if there was any financial incentive to shut the truck down, there are companies out there that are like, hey, in bad weather, if you just decide to stop, we'll pay you $100, you know, just to stop the truck, because that's way cheaper than the cost of a tow truck, whatever, cleanup, any accidents, anything like that, right? But $100 doesn't make sense to a truck driver. I mean, it's fantastic that these trucking companies have at least taken that initiative. There's only a few of them that do it that I know of, but have at least taken that initiative to say, hey, you know what, just shut it down. But $100 still isn't enough compared to what we would make by running the truck. So yes, the answer is yes. There are obviously times where the way we are paid forces us, I think, into not making the greatest decision. But as we descend, these roads are getting a little bit better. They are getting a little bit better. I'm not excited at all about how much brake I'm having to use. And I have her geared down, guys. I have her geared down. Don't worry. But not excited about that at all. I mean, I'm not riding them constantly, but I'll run it down to 15. And by the time you're like, okay, we can rest a minute, and it'll run up to 25 within seconds. Within seconds. So, it's not a whole lot of fun, if I'm being honest with you. This is not my favorite trip down this mountain. So I'm going to go ahead and finish this. Not much more to say right now. The roads are starting to get a little better as we get down this mountain, and that is exciting. So probably next time I talk to you, I will either be tipped over sideways in a ditch, or I will have made it to my destination. I guess we'll see. Talk soon. Yeah, this is what I really look like. Hey, what's up, guys? We did it. Haven't made it to delivery yet, but we're here at the bottom of the mountain. And we are going to... I was not comfortable with how much I was using the brakes, so we're going to give them a few minutes. I don't know if that's my brakes I'm smelling or someone else's, but we are stopped safely at the bottom. With that ice and everything, it was just pushing us down the mountain and with this heavy load. That's probably the most I've ever used the brakes coming off a mountain, and that was not great. But we are here, we're stopped. Somebody's brakes are definitely putting off an odor. Could be mine, who knows. But we're here, we made it. I'm gonna get my chains off, and I'm just gonna give them like 10 minutes or so to just let you know, chill out, cool down a little bit. And then we'll hit the road. We'll hit the road. But what a day. What a day. I've still got, I think it's almost 5 a.m. now. So 6 hours to go 294 miles. We're pushing it. We're getting close. But hey, you know what? We'll get it there. Talk to you guys soon. I got to get these chains off. Now that's real trucking, baby. What are you talking to me about? Apple orchards or some bullshit like that? No, baby. That's how you get it done right there. We've done it, guys. We're on the dock. We're backed in. They moved my appointment to 11, so I slept in. I think I mentioned that. That's the unfortunate part about doing videos in parts. Forgot what I was talking about in the last one. So, hey, we made it, though. They switched my appointment to 11. We got here at like 10:20 because I decided to sleep in. But I went straight into like the middle of Seattle. Not like straight into it, but right around the downtown area. Never, ever been that close to the actual city of Seattle before. I've always gone around on like 205 and things like that. So it was kind of cool. Saw the Seahawks stadium. I always try to see all the football stadiums as I go around the country. So that's the first time I saw that. But I was looking for the Space Needle. I found it, but it was very underwhelming compared to all the other buildings over there. It's very small in comparison. So if any of you are ever excited to see the iconic Space Needle, I mean, it's cool, I guess, but like compared to all the other buildings in Seattle, it's just you gotta look for it. So hey, we got it done, guys, and gotta be happy with that. I want to make fun of the angry people from the last video again real quick. You always know when a video is doing well, and thank you guys, that one did very well. But when you start getting a bunch of angry people you've never seen before, just like pissed off in the comment section, like you're just making a video and then like the people from the fucking hills have eyes are in your comments, you dumb as hell, boy. Yeah, I am. You got me. I'm dumb as shit. So yeah, you got me figured out. Hey, I'm happy it did so well. I think that was really cool. I don't have a whole lot left to say. What am I trying to remember here? Oh, I told dispatch I want my next load assigned to me because that's why I busted my ass to get here, right? And they have not yet. So I got a little bit of a situation because one, I don't know which way I'm going from here. And Seattle is a very, very not friendly city for parking trucks. So I don't really know which way to go from here. I'm gonna let them unload me and then I'm just gonna have to look for the closest thing. Now, I need them to assign me something today because that's what's gonna make this a big week, right? Like we've been discussing. And that's very important to me to have a killer week this week. So we'll see what they do. The good news is if they assign me something by tomorrow at the latest, they can always backdate that for me so it goes on the same pay period. I've always, you know, I've had a few times where I've asked them to do that or the week was going to really suck. So I don't know what their plan is. I'm not sure what they got going for us. Let's see, what do I got for hours? Does anyone care about this? I mean, I've got 14 hours left on my 70, and I'm gaining 4.5 tonight, so that's 18, yeah, about 19 hours, somewhere in there. Hell, that's almost 2 full days still that I got out in front of me once I recap tonight, so they could definitely find me something, but if they want me to shut down and save my hours and just recap, we can work around that too, but there we go, baby. We got it done. All these years of hearing that I'm not a real trucker and all those people that have told me I'm not a real trucker, ain't seen them do what I just did. Nope, never seen them out there throwing those chains on. Never saw it, not once. Never see them coming off that mountain when it's covered in snow and ice. Never seen it. Never seen it. So, hey, baby, if I'm a fake trucker, I'll take it. I'll take it. We got shit done tonight. And that mountain did make me nervous. It did. For, I think, the first time ever. It kind of really bothered me the way the road conditions were, but we made it, and I'm gonna take a fucking nap. That's what I'm gonna do, and wait for dispatch to say something. That's what I'm gonna do. So bye till next time, guys. See you on the next video.